Hello everybody, welcome back to Embertronics. In our previous tutorial, we have written the device driver and created the device file in the dev directory. In the previous video, we tried to read and write this device file, but we got the error called no such a device or address. Why that has happened? Because we have just created the device file, but we have not assigned any file operations to it. In this video, we are going to add file operations in the device driver, and we will link those file operations to the device file. So when the application reads or writes to the device file, then the specific function will be getting called. Let's get into the action. Please check this tutorial for the complete information. I have provided the links in the description. First, we will see the CDEV structure. This is the CDEV structure and it has these members. We have to create a CDEV structure and initialize it. There are two ways to create the CDEV structure. One is runtime allocation and another one is the static allocation. Runtime allocation is nothing but just using the CDEV alloc function that will allocate the memory for the CDEV structure and returns the pointer. Here, we have to assign our file operations manually. In the static method, we will just create the CDEV structure and pass that structure to the CDEV init function with the file operation. This function initializes the CDEV structure. Once after the initialization, we have to add that CDEV structure with our device driver using the CDEV add function. It has three arguments. First is the CDEV structure address. The second one is the major and minor number. And the third one is the number of devices. If you want to delete the CDEV, we can use the CDEV del function with the CDEV structure's address. Now, we will see the file operations. This file operations structure can be found in the linux.fs.h. This structure has many function pointer members for llseq, read, write, and many more. We have to create the function based on our need, then assign that function address to the respective function pointer. Then these file operations will be initialized with the CDEV structure using the CDEV init. Mostly, we will implement read, write, ioctl, open, and close function. So, the address of those functions will be assigned to the members like this. You will understand it in a better way while we go through the code. This is the example source code that we are going to use. Here, I have created the CDEV structure. I have created this file operations function. In this file operations structure, I am assigning those functions. In the open function, I am not doing anything other than the simple debug print. Doing the same thing in all other functions like close, read, write functions. In the init function, I am allocating the major and minor numbers, then initializing the CDEV structure with the file operations using the CDEV init function. After that, I am calling the CDEV function with the CDEV structure, device number and count. Then I am creating the class structure followed by the device file creation. In the exit function, we are clearing the CDEV structure using the CDEV del function. So whenever we open the device file, this etx open function should be called. This etx release function has to be called when we close that device file, and for reading and writing, this etx read and etx write function will be called respectively. I am using this make file to build the device driver. Let's build the device driver. Load the driver using ins mode. See, our etx file is here. In the Raspberry Pi also, the device file is created. Check the D message. Our driver is loaded. Now we will try to write the data to our device file using the echo command. Okay, permission denied. Let's enter as an admin by entering the sudo su. Now we will run the echo command. Let's check the D message. See here, our driver's open function, write function and close function have been called. When we write the data, it will open the file, write it and close it. In the Raspberry Pi also, we can see the same output. Now we will read the data from the device file using the cat command. Now the open function, read function and close function have been called. Let's test the same stuff in the Raspberry Pi. Same output. Now we will test the same code in the BeagleBone board. Let's cross compile the driver. Now we will copy the driver.ko to the target BeagleBone board using the rsync. Just open the serial terminal. ls, see, our driver.ko file is available. Let's load it. Check the D message. The driver has been loaded. Sudo su. Now we will write the data to the device file using the echo command. Check the D message. See, it has called the open, write and close function. Now we will try to read. See, it has called the open, read and close functions. Instead of using the echo and cat command to write and read the device file, you can write the user space application and read or write the device file. In our next tutorial, we will write the real device driver. If you want to get the alerts when we post a new video like this, then please subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon. See you again with a new tutorial. Thank you.